divisional round of the NFL playoffs, and it's brought to you by EA Sports. It's the Bills and the Ravens coming up next.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL playoffs brings us to the home of the Ravens. Sold out M&T Bank Stadium in Baltimore, Maryland. Straight ahead, we punch the second of two tickets to the AFC title game. And we've got a great win in store, as it'll be the Buffalo Bills taking on the Baltimore Ravens. Hello, everyone. As the postseason continues here on EA Sports, we're pleased to bring it to you. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaudin. And who has the edge here? You got one side that had some extra rest, but another comes in off a win last week in the wild card round.
And it's funny, depending on which team you are, you say that that's an advantage. You'll take the rest. You'll take the week off. Get your guys healed up a little bit and ready to go. But that team that's coming in off of a win last week, they're really excited to keep playing. They feel like they are hot and ready to go.
Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. Here comes the Ravens on offense, and the man in charge from Louisville, the former MVP, Lamar Jackson.
And he and his team, they were the beneficiaries of a first-round bye earned by a tremendous regular season. He'd been a little bit nicked up so he could use the rest, and I'm sure his teammates felt the exact same way. But now it'll be interesting to watch their first few drives in this one, because sometimes getting the rest is great, but sometimes you accumulate a little bit of rust as well. Maybe they come out flat, and they can't afford that in the postseason.
Off the play fake, here's Jackson. That ball caught, it's Mark Andrews, the tight end. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. That's a pickup of 11 and a first down on their first offensive play.
Good job there to locate his tight end, Charles, in the middle of the field.
Yeah, he has good pass-catching abilities, and if they're able to continue to find him here in the early going, I think it'll help out his teammates out on the perimeter. You can take the big shots later if he occupies their attention. All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
From the 44-yard line, here's second and six. Now Jackson. And is going to be off the mark, too far out in front.
What touch and time are critical for those types of throws? He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
Well, now they'll try the end around. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. 25 yards that time.
This is one of those plays that has an equal chance of either being a big gain or a big loss. But with the college influence, we're seeing more of these plays come into the NFL.
So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory, down at the 31. Here's Jackson to throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Von Miller doing what he does best with a sack. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Jackson. The short throw caught by Andrews. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And third and eight now.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. Not at all what they envisioned on third down. 3 yards in the wrong direction. A 49-yard attempt. Tucker's kick is good. And the Ravens strike first at 3-0.
every possession in the postseason magnified. And look, it's just the opening drive. They didn't get the touchdown they wanted, but at least they got on the board.
They got on the board. They've got their home crowd into it as well. And remember, in the playoffs, the game slows down a little bit, so every point is precious.
And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. For the Buffalo offense coming out, and it is Josh Allen who is at the helm.
All in all, he was pretty solid in the victory in the wild card round and threw a couple of touchdowns. And when it comes to quarterback play, you'd always love spectacular. But in the playoffs, you'll take solid. And that's exactly what they're looking for from him again in this contest.
And this will be incomplete. Now a second and 10. Here's Allen. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 11 yards and a Buffalo first down. To throw once more. They're unable to connect, but a late flag comes in. And the contact may have come too early. So they saw the contact before the ball arrived. Penalty flag for pass interference.
And trying to avoid pass interference is so difficult. You're trying to slow down these skilled receivers, and somehow, some way, they make plays on the football. And sometimes you're there too soon.
And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. So they fake the handoff. Now Allen. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble. And it's second down.
4 yards on the pickup.
Allen now looks to throw. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. That's already the third time they've looked his way on this opening drive. He's caught one of the three.
That doesn't mean they won't continue to go in that direction. It feels like they think they've got something good going there, and they think those numbers are going to increase.
And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of two there. Sean McDermott didn't hesitate. They'll go for it on fourth. Allen gonna go on fourth down. Toward the sideline, intercepted. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown. Well, CD, we have seen it many times throughout the course of the season. This defense coming up large and snagging a big takeaway. But here they get not just the takeaway, 6 points as well.
And you just knew that for this team to advance, it had to get a big performance from this unit. And to this point, they've delivered.
Jackson and the Ravens still on the field. They'll go for two. And they'll try a little razzle-dazzle. And he will get into the end zone. So the lead stretches from 9 up to 11. And there's a quick momentum swing. INT return for a pick six, and then the two-point conversion good.
And even if you're keeping your wits about you, you're thinking to yourself, okay, extra point block team going into the game now. All of a sudden you're hearing defense. Everyone's scrambling for their helmets and throwing down their cups of water. That's a great position for them to be in, trying to score against that team. A little bit disjointed.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They're forced to play catch-up early in this division round game as they search for a seat in the AFC Championship round. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down.
Tackle made at the 38-yard line. A gain of 21 yards. First down, Bill.
11-0 our score after one.
The Bills with the football as we start quarter number two. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. As they've got it as we resume action. On first down, Allen. That's caught by Gabriel Davis. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Second down and a yard. Up the middle, it's Cook. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
They bring him down right at the 45. 53 yards rushing for him now. He's only carried the ball 4 times. First down, here's the run with Cook. And he'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
On second down, here's the option. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. A gain of 8 on the keeper and a first down. Now they'll throw with Allen. Gets this one to Morris. Short completion, just 4 yards, and that will bring up second down.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
Now Allen throwing on second down. Getting the football to Davis on an out route. And he's going to be taken down right at the 10-yard line.
I tell you what, it looks like he's shaking off that pick 6 just fine. It's not just defensive backs that have to have short memories. Quarterbacks utilize that as well. A much more confident throw right there.
And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Couldn't get that one to his man. Short of him, it's low and incomplete. Throwing is Allen on third. He will find Diggs in the end zone. Touchdown, Buffalo. 10 yards on the touchdown pass. And the Bills have cut it back within a score. Extra point by Bass, up and good. And the lead is down to 4. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. This taken in at the goal line. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Baltimore set to take over here for their second possession of the game. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
They'll try a little trickery here on the end around. Oh, good move. It's a pickup of 11 at a Baltimore first down. And quickly, they get to the line.
And the Baltimore first down. First and 10 at the 38-yard line.
Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. This throw taken in by Isaiah Likely. For the 44 now, here's second and 4. Now it's Jackson. And that is incomplete.
The coverage was good, but I just wonder if they absolutely fooled the quarterback on that play. I think he was expecting something else. Ended up with nowhere to throw the football successfully.
Oh, a design run for their wideout. And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. And they're going to at least line up to go for it here on fourth down. Oh, look at this play call. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. A surprise. And I believe they buzzed down. They're going to take another look at this play with all reviews coming from the replay official here in the final 2 minutes. First down, and they're going to throw with Allen. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Allen. Now, quick throw there is incomplete. A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they threw it. Now with the short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
So, Charles, this a defense that hasn't made a lot of mistakes like this on the road to this playoff matchup, but that a bad one there.
Yeah, you definitely want to rattle and shake up the other quarterback, but you know you've got to do it the right way. Otherwise,
touchdown, Bills! Reggie Gilliam from 19 yards away. And the Bills will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point by Bass, up and good. And that gives him a 3-point lead. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And that'll be a little too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone for a touchback here. The Ravens going to get one more drive here in this first half. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
A big one there for the Ravens. It goes for 18. One play has them up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. And they'll go on the ground. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. They give him a gain of 37. So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10. And they'll run it here. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Ravens touchdown. Devin Duvernay in the final seconds of the first half. And the Ravens have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half.
Well, someone has a sense of the dramatic here, don't they? Scoring this late in the half to take the lead going into the locker room.
Now they just don't want to misstep misfortune on the next kickoff because there's still a little bit of time left on that clock.
Yeah, you do have to bring that up, don't you? In the NFL, every play is critical. And if you give up something cheap there, all that advantage they just gained goes right out the window.
Maybe time for one play on offense. 7 seconds to go in the half as the kick is away. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. And you wonder if with Allen's arm, they might just take their chances by dialing up a long one. And now this throw incomplete, and that is how this first half will come to an end. So it's on to halftime of this AFC divisional round matchup. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. This fourth and final matchup on this divisional round.
Well, look around the NFL. We'll have to wait for postgame because we are moving right through halftime and on to the third quarter. We welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn getting set for quarter number three here. Win or go home, that's the name of the game, and we're back underway with the second half of this AFC divisional round. And able to get
get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line.
Out come the Bills now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter.
And Charles, that had to be an interesting locker room at halftime. This is a team that's had so much success this year. Haven't really had to deal with a lot of adversity at halftime, to be honest. But now here they are with their playoff lives on the line.
And I think when you're alluding to that interesting locker room, you're just wondering, how are they handling that bit of adversity that they're seeing right now? Because I think this is a team that has to look to lean on the veterans at this point. We know we're better than this. We've proved it all season. Let them disseminate that confidence through the locker room. But this opening drive, it'll be an important one for them to give them a little jolt of confidence moving forward.
Here's second and 10. A give to the fullback on the dive. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5.
I love the modern game, but that was a throwback right there to see the big man with football running, knocking people aside, and picking up yardage. That takes me back to the 60s, the 70s.
With Stephon Diggs. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. On the give, this is their fullback. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. 5 yards, a good run there, and now second and goal. And they'll let the fullback try and take him home. And he takes it in across the chalk for a Bills touchdown.
Reggie Gilliam,
his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bills have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. And he'll get into the end zone to push the lead up to a field goal. So that effort gives him a 3-point cushion and guarantees that a field goal going forward won't beat them.
Yeah, that's really good strategy because that's all you care about. Not getting beat at this stage, at least give your team a fighting chance.
And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 21. So a loss of 5, and it'll be second down. And they'll go with a ground attack here. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of 4.
But not a big gain with that play, but what they're doing is they're spreading the defense out, probing a little bit, and what they're hoping probably is that later in the game they can create a matchup that they can exploit for big yardage later.
And after all that, he's going to get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave them with a fourth down. The Ravens send their punter out now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. Fielded at the 33. A very nice punt that time, but they get 11 back on the return. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here.
This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. They've gone to their fullback quite a bit. He'll get it again.
Travis Jones makes a tackle.
A good solid game there on first down, but the defense has to be happy. They didn't let it pop for anything bigger.
Now Allen. This to the tight end, Kincaid. Call it a gain of 3 on the play. And they're going to face a third down. One quarter remains for the right to advance to the AFC title game. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Baltimore. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. 2 yards on the pickup there. And that'll bring up fourth down. Going quickly out to the right side. Championship game. Off we go in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. And he returns this to the 22. Allen looking to throw it right at the outset. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. The game's first play produces 6 yards. Brings up second down.
A 6 yard pickup brings up second and 4 at the 28 yard line.
Here's Allen to throw it. And his throw here is incomplete.
How about that? Red man coverage and decided to test him early. But it turned up to the task and forced the incompletion.
And they'll look to avoid an early 3 and out here on 3rd and 4. To throw, it's Allen. Setting up the screen for Cook. And he is going to have a Bills first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of 6. To the air, Allen. That's brought in by Davis over the middle. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play, and it'll be second down. Again, they'll throw with Allen. A short throw pulled in by Kincaid, and he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well. They run for the first time with James Cook. And he'll manage to pick up about 4 at second down.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
On second down, Cook. And he stopped immediately there. They'll say no gain on the play there. Now it'll be third down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Allen gonna throw. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he's gonna be taken down with the first down at the Ravens 34-yard line. Throwing on first down is Allen. Got it complete to Khalil Shakir. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. And how about this first drive? They're being aggressive, slinging it around.
Really confident, too, because they're not trying to fool them with running plays. Throwing it, and they're being very successful right now.
Play action. Now it's Allen. Oh, it's intercepted. A drive killer there. Picked up by Patrick Queen. And the Ravens are going to take over here on the INT at their own 5-yard line. And certainly, look, you're on the road in the playoffs. That is a suboptimal start, opening drive INT.
And, partner, sometimes I wonder, Do these teams talk about it to such an extent that maybe you almost talk yourself into the turnover when you're trying to avoid it?
Yeah, maybe they get a little too worried about keeping the football, and then you give it to the other team right off the bat. And look, we said it, on the road, this is just a terrible, terrible start for them.
It is, and now they've got to rely on their defense.
They'll get it in the hands of Beckham. And space opened up a bit. He's able to take this out past the 10. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
A 7-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 3 at the 12.
And he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain that time, as it's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 3 to go.
It's 3rd down and 4.
And they'll go on the ground. And he's going to have the 1st down as he's marked down just shy of the 20. Move the chains, a gain of 7 on 3rd down.
Well, when we go back to our conversation with the defensive coordinator, that type of a play was not a surprise to him. He expected trickery in this game, yet somehow his defense, they still took the cheese and got caught in the mousetrap.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on 1st and 10. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. The decision to keep it turns out to be a good one. 11 yards in the 1st down.
It looked like almost a miscommunication defensively, because once he decided to keep it, he had pretty smooth sailing.
Yeah, it became a question of, wait a minute, who's got the quarterback? And when you talk about miscommunication, it's supposed to be called assignment football on the defensive side of the ball. But the assignment gets mixed up. That's the end result.
No score after 1 on EA Sports. 2nd quarter now from Baltimore. It's the Ravens in possession, as they've got a 2nd and 8 forthcoming. Here's Jackson to throw. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
Those are the ones you dream of as defenders. I think if he gets eyes on the ball a little bit earlier, he might come away with it. Instead, it's going to wind up as just an incomplete pass.
And they'll run it here. And good running there as he'll take this all the way out to midfield. Jackson now off the bootleg. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage. But I think.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. And a great job there to read that one defensively. They strung him out, would not allow him to cut up field. This offense has converted 2 3rd downs on this drive already. This is 3rd and 4. And they'll go on the ground. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the 1st. Only 1 yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a 4th down.
A gain of only 1 yard. It's 4th down.
They'll run for it. It's Edwards. And he's not even still picking up the 1st. They stop it right at the line of scrimmage. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make 2nd down, 2nd and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.